Buddy, Mark Speck the Comics, and I'm back. This time with my new comic book day, top picks of the week. Sorry, I was not able to make one for last week. I was still unpacking from my trip back home. Had a lot going on, so I didn't have a chance to do that. Or my Moon Knight episode 5 breakdown, which I'm going to end up doing a series finale anyways. But you guys are here for my top picks for new comic book day. I'm going to limit them to 5 this week. I think it's a bit of a light week. So this should be a pretty quick video for you guys. And let's start with, before I get into my top picks, I want to thank my channel sponsor, Brabadier & Sons, for sponsoring this video and channel. They do have a new comic book coming out on Thursday, May 12th for pre-order. It's Bunny Mask issue number 2. Artwork done by Lyrics Art, which is a part of Art Germs Collectibles. So look out for this artist. It's going to be up and coming. So I think this cover's fire. Check it out. Go on Bombardier & Sons shop website. Link is in the description, IG, and all his information. Really cool. Check out that website and pre-order that if that's something you're into. So for picks for this week, like I said, we got 5. And pretty late week. I'm going to start with, let's do Marvel this week for number 5. And the first one is going to be written by Donny Cates. It's going to be Hulk versus Thor Banner of War Alpha, number 1. It's going to be a one-shot kickoff of a crossover event that continues into Thor 25 and Hulk number 7. So like I said, it's going to be written by Donny Cates, so that's why it has the tie-ins to the other issues. There's going to be some, I don't want to spoil it, but there's going to be some key books that it ties into from his previous series. I'll just leave it at that. So that's number 5 this week. Number 4 this week is also going to be from Marvel, and this was a bit of an anticipated series that's been in the works for quite some time, and this was even prior to the Moon Knight series dropping. And I don't know if there's going to be as much interest now, because I think a lot of people are going to be kind of over the whole Moon Knight thing, but I'm going to be interested in reading it anyways, because it is going to be written by Jonathan Hickman. And this is Moon Knight Black, White, and Blood, issue number 4, issue number 1, sorry. It's a 4-issue limited series, anthology of stories. There is going to be the first appearance of the last living priestess of Khonshu, a vigilante who operates 6,000 years into the future. I believe it's cover B that has the cover appearance. So I'm going to recommend that one as the pickup for that book. I'm going to read it, issue 1, and see how it goes from there. I don't have too many like high hopes for the series. Some people, there's like a love and hate interest for Jonathan Hickman. I'm on the fence just because he can be quite verbose, and sometimes it gets lost in the overall meaning of the story. So that's why it's like, you know, back and forth. So depending on the what he's writing. So that's my number 4 for this week. Number 3 this week is going to be coming from, let's see, DC. And this is going to be a cover buy. So this is Blood Syndicate Season 1, Number 1, The 1 in 25 by Raza. This cover looks absolutely amazing. As we would say, it's absolutely fire. And if you look at that cover, the guy's blowing out fire. It's well detailed. It just looks stunning. And I think DC is doing something here. You know, bringing some back of these milestone characters. You know, they got Static, they got Blood Syndicate, and who is the other one that's already out? I'm drawing a blank, but it's going to come to me later. But they've all had, you know, returns from their milestone imprints. So Blood Syndicate is the next one. So who knows? Maybe they're trying to do maybe a crossover for the whenever that Static movie comes out, which I believe is going to be directed by Michael B. Jordan. So The 1 in 25 is going to be my number 3 this week. So, for number 2, and this nearly made my number 1. The only reason it did not make my number 1 this week is because there were so many covers. And whenever there are so many covers, I get a little worried that it's going to be a massive print run. And this is coming from Boom Studios. This is Grimm number 1. So it's a woman, has been recruited to be a reaper in the afterlife, but is plagued by the mystery of how she died. Sounds like right on my alley. I like reading this horror stuff. Sounds very interesting. The last time we had something like this that was pretty anticipated from Boom Studios, it was, you guessed it, Something is Killing the Children. So I'm not comparing it to Something is Killing the Children, but I'm just saying with this much hype leading into a debut, that's what I'm comparing it to. There are some gorgeous covers. There is this really cool Virgin variant done by Jenny Frizen, which comic shops will receive one copy of this variant if they order 100 copies of the J. Lee FOC variant, which the J. Lee cover is actually pretty badass, if I can say so myself. That's also a 1 in 75. So shops were pretty incentivized to pre-order these in order to get some of these crazy like FOC copies. So unless you have a really big comic shop, not a lot of people are going to get this Grimm 1 in 100 FOC variant, which looks amazing as well. So there's a lot of covers to choose from. Take whatever one you like. You know, you can't go wrong. A lot of these are amazing. So that's my number 2 this week. Like I said, just missed my number 1. Only because of that caveat. So for number 1 this week, this is a title I talked about maybe a month ago that also hit number 1 this week, and that was the hottest book of the week. So, not saying this is going to be the hottest book of the week, but it's the book I'm most excited for and has a little bit of speculation behind it. And that is Sandman Universe Nightmare Country number 2. So there's some solicitation that there could be a first full appearance of the Smiling Man. I don't believe the Smiling Man does appear in this issue, so there is that. There is a really cool 1 in 25 and 1 in 50 Francesco Martina cover that has the cover appearance of the Smiling Man on there, but I don't believe the actual character, you know, will show up in this issue. But the story's been fantastic. It's written by James Tynion IV. Great interior artwork. The covers have been amazing. If you remember that first one with 1 in 100 Jenny Frizen cover of Death on it, whoo, that cover is still hot, selling in upwards of well over $300. This one has a 1 in 25 and a 1 in 50. The 1 in 50 is a foil, so that's the difference. Cover looks amazing. But yeah, that's my number 1 pick of the week. Hopefully you guys enjoy that. Let me know what you're picking up for New Comic Book Day. Write it in the comments down below. Hit the thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. Check out Bombardier & Sons shop so you can get that exclusive for Bunny Mask. That artist is up and coming. Trust me on that one. All right, guys. Until next week, it's Mark Spector Comics. Out.